good time to spend an evening with me. And if we go someplace to dance, I know that there's a chance you won't be leaving with me. Then afterwards we drop into a quiet little place and have a drink or two.
It is now social time. I'm heading downstairs to meet Biani because we're going together to social. Tonight is merengue night. So we will see what we have in store for tonight. Dead pouring. Oh my gosh, like it's like so windy to so my hood doesn't stay up. I was like holding it with my hands and then my hands got cold, but it's freezing. I'm about to go back under the rain, so. All right guys, it's much later now. I am finishing getting ready. We're going to a UB like late night, late talk, late night at UB or whatever, hosted by RHA. Lasa's gonna be performing. It's gonna be fun.
1, 2, 3, arm wrestle.
Oh.
Fuck it up, Tim! Yeah,
one,
Tim!
2, 3!
Tim!
American Student Association's Alma Nanichi Dance Team.
Day. Today I am blending up a smoothie. I recently bought this pack from Target and I love it. At Starbucks there's this drink. I get the strawberry lemonade with dragon fruit inclusion and double blended, and it's like a dragon fruit like slushy and it's so good. And I basically replicated this with these fruits. I'm gonna add some almond milk. My body's literally so sore from the gym already, but I'm gonna go back today. I'm really excited. I found out that like the technique that I'm gonna use is like I'm gonna read or like listen to an audiobook while I'm on the treadmill, and like I'm excited to like finish reading my book. So I'm just like, okay, like I can't wait to go to the gym so I can listen to the rest of it. So that's like kind of like my motivation and putting together two things so that way I can feel more inspired and motivated to go to the gym. Guys, look at this. It's like the perfect consistency. So good.
Then afterwards words would drop into a quiet little place and have a drink or two.
What'd she say?
Vianney.
What did
they say, Vianney?
What are you doing?
She wanted to talk about something.
What are you doing? I'm vlogging.
It's don't weird when you're like...
Don't be stupid.
Come home, the kids miss you.
What?
Mom.
Stop trying to close the door.
Why?
Because I don't want it closed.
Well, why?
Don't you think you should be wearing black Tims with that fit?
Good morning, guys. I woke up and I'm studying. I have an exam today. It's for my computer science class. So I need to get myself together. I only have like a few more minutes to study because I have to leave so I can get there at a decent time and I'm not like rushing.
And then I go and spoil it all by saying something stupid like
guys, let me literally just tell you what just happened while I clean up my desk. For one of my classes, I had to do an interview, or like a mock interview thing. So I was assuming like, okay, she's just gonna ask me like very basic job questions based off some sort of like fake job title. Like she's gonna give me some sort of description, whatever. Like there was no information given. I'm also kind of an idiot for this, but I didn't bring a resume. And so the first thing she asked me was like, oh, did you bring like a resume? And I was just like, no. And in that moment, I was like, Kathleen, L, big L. Earlier in the semester, we had to submit like a job with like a resume and a cover letter, and like technically it was due like last week, but she said we could submit it at any point in time. So I'm like, bet, I'm gonna submit my homework early. I submitted it like a whole month ago. The interview was based off of that today. Like I just didn't know these things. And so like I'm just sitting there and I'm just like, oh my gosh, she asked me a question about the job, so I'm making up some shit. She's like, oh, like what stood out to you the most about like the comp, or no, what's the company's mission statement, or how does the company's mission statement speak to you? Girl, I don't even know what the mission statement is. But that resume, bro, I have a feeling that that's gonna hurt me. She's gonna do me dirty for that. I don't know why I didn't think to bring it. Like, there was just, like, no information given. And I thought it was just gonna be based off of questions. I didn't think it was gonna be, like, an actual thing. Like, I literally walked in there and I was like, hey, professor. And she was just like, hi, it's nice to meet you. Like, pretending to be the interviewee. And I'm just like, oh.
We're just rescuing two delinquents from being arrested. That's what I wanna talk about. Hey, Rich, I'm gonna build you a house out of bread.
What's your favorite kind of bread?
You gotta get that potato bread, baby.
I'm from Erie, so...
You're from where? Erie?
Don't fucking say
my favorite bread is Italian bread.
Fuck out of here.
Shut up.
You're not from
Italian bread. But today I'm going to try new, something new. Kenya or maybe Tanzania to see those, what do you call it?
Yeah, you look like a tourist. She looks like a tourist.
Safari. Why are you laughing?
I don't know. I started coughing. Popped in his face. I'm sorry.
Is that?
I will not stand until you tell me. It's already stolen. We could just take it.
I can see it in your eyes that you despise the same old lines you heard the night before. Just lying to you, for me it's true, it never seemed so right before. I practice every day to find some clever lines to say to make the meaning come through. But then I think I'll wait until the evening gets late and I'm alone with you. The time is right, your perfume fills my head. The stars get red and all the nights so blue. And then I go and spoil it all by saying something stupid like I love you. Like I love.